convener Professor Venkat Krishna, convener CC Code 19 and co-convener Professor M. Usharani, dignitaries of the dais, my colleagues from our department and other departments, scholars, students, delegates, participants, non-teaching staff, press and electronic media, a very good morning to all of you. The convener of the conference, Professor Venkat Krishna, spoke the conference objectives and how many papers received from different universities. It is a part of the conference series started in 2018. This conference mainly focuses on advanced computer science areas like intelligent systems, artificial intelligence, computer vision, etc., and how it applies from this international conference deliberations. I wish this conference a great success. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Dr. Sudha Garu. Now my request of the chief guest of this function, our respected beloved Vice Chancellor in charge, to speak.
Professor Mohammad Mubarak, the distinguished keynote speaker who has come all the way from Jordan. Professor Nagaraj, Dean School of Sciences and the President of today's inaugural session. All the dignitaries on the dais, senior faculty, distinguished participants who have come from different parts of the country, and my dear students. I deem it a pleasure to be here this morning and say a few words on this occasion. While I am delighted that the Department of Computer Science is organizing a series of events at the international level on computing, communication, and data engineering. As already mentioned, this is the second in the series. And I congratulate Professor Venkat Krishna for taking the initiative to conduct these conferences. Not only because it helps our own students from the computer science department and also from the School of Engineering and Technology to update themselves, but also it helps in enhancing the visibility of this university at the international level. It also helps to place this university at a higher level because we are associating ourselves and we are indulging in conducting events which are of most recent trends. And computer science department is one of the oldest departments in this university, with good number of senior faculty working there for years and having been the nodal officer for facilitating the assessment and accreditation by NAC. I have realized, and I have to make a mention of that, the good number of publications are coming from the Department of Computer Science and adding to the credit of the university. So I also congratulate them on this behalf. And Professor Venkat Krishna came and asked me to be the chief guest, and I said, why me? Because I'm a social scientist. And within social sciences, I'm a qualitative researcher, very away from numbers. But he said, because you are sitting as the in-charge vice chancellor, you have to come. So I did agree to come, but ask him to brief me as to what I should be talking. So he's given me some talking points which are Greek and Latin to me. So I decided to set that aside, except to understand that computing, communication, and data engineering technologies are critical, and they have to be addressed, they have to be looked at in order to realize the vision of 2030. So since they have chosen this topic to work on a continuous basis as a series of workshops, I started to learn a little and I'm enjoying it. Okay, after particularly sitting in the administrative position for the last 3 years. And the most challenging thing for me when I went there was to work towards the automation process in the university, which has not been easy at all. It's been going on for the last 4 or 5 years. But during the last 1 year, we have been seeing the fruits of the efforts that have been taken up by the university. And it's really been an enjoyable moment when we are seeing the results of this effort of automation process. So in this context, I think it needs to be mentioned that ICT plays a key role, particularly for integration, for updating, to bring people together, to have data at your fingertips, to make use of it, to look at the trends, and for administrators like us, to help us plan in terms of where the real action and intervention need to take place in institutions like Sri Padmavati Mahila Vishwavidyalaya. I think it's being looked at, the type of development that is taking place in ICT, I think is being looked at as a third wave, while first wave has been considered as the agricultural revolution, and the second wave, the industrial revolution, and the third wave, it is being mentioned in literature as the IT revolution. When we are all happy about the IT revolution that is taking place, it is also an area of concern in terms of how it is being utilized and to what extent it is being productive, and on the other hand, the type of problems that are coming up because of addiction and excess use of IT. The human touch. So I'm not sure what will happen to all the people who are sitting here in the next 10 years. Maybe we will be talking only to machines and to robots who will be doing all our work rather than talking to people and seeking help from each other, which in social sciences is very important to us because of the human relations that we need to sustain. The internet, we are seeing how it is spearheading, and it is a consultative and a participatory global culture. E-governance is another area that we are really working towards in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And as many of you know, Andhra Pradesh is a very encouraging platform for the type of topics that we are discussing here. Because of our Chief Minister, who is so tech-savvy and who believes that all answers lie in IT. So institutions are really being pushed. But I think it is worth the push because of the benefits that they are seeing, whether it is the student attendance or the scholarship type of thing that we are seeing, the payments that have been made online. So the things are becoming more and more systematic, and they are becoming more accountable in the administrative processes. So that is where I really like the type of contribution that the technology is making to promote good governance in institutions. So the link between these two, the technology and the good governance, I think is what I would like to make a mention of in this context. And as I mentioned, we have introduced the office automation system, and in a couple of months we would like to move towards a paperless administration in this university. And thanks to all the faculty who are working in this direction and making it possible. In the context of the international conference, the theme was decided as Computing, Communication and Data Engineering. And Professor Venkatakrishna, who is the convener, has made mention that this particular series of conferences is becoming very popular, because of which there is participation and papers are being received from not international and national level and institutes of high repute. So I'm really happy about the response that is coming to this particular conference, and good number of experts, I was told, are also joining by Skype, which is yet another contribution of the technology. People don't have to be present, physically present here in order to make the contribution to important topics like this. So I take this opportunity to congratulate the Department of Computer Science for organizing this conference. I am also happy to learn that this has been well received, not only by the academia, but also the representatives of the industry. I wish the deliberations of the conference a grand success, and I hope all the participants and the delegates who have come here will benefit out of the proceedings during the next 2 days and make the best use of it. Though I know that the main attraction is the volume of the Springer that is going to come out. Wish you all the best and wish the conference a grand success.
Thank you, madam, for your address. Very apt for this occasion. Now, I request Professor M. Usha Rani, the co-convener of this conference, to introduce the keynote speaker.
It's an honor to introduce Dr. Mohammad S. Obedat, the keynote speaker of this conference. So we are very happy that you are here today. He is now full professor at the King Abdullah II School of Information Technology, the University of Jordan, and the full professor at Nazar Bawe University, Astana, Tajikistan. He is an internationally well-known academician and scientist. He received his PhD from Ohio State University, Columbus, Ohio, USA. He rendered his services even to Fordham University, Monmouth University, Prince Sultan University, Philadelphia University, and Amity University. He has received extensive research funding and published about 1,000 refereed technical articles. About half of them are journal articles, over 65 books, and over 65 book chapters. He is editor-in-chief of 3 scholarly journals and an editor of many other international journals. He is the founding editor-in-chief of Willing Security and Privacy Journal. He has chaired 160 international conferences and has given more than 150 keynote speeches worldwide. He has served as Abbott at CSAP evaluator and an IEEE CS Fellow Evaluation Committee. He has served as IEEE CS Distinguished Speaker and Lecturer and an ACM Distinguished Lecturer. Since 2004, he has been serving as an SCS Distinguished Lecturer. He received many best paper awards for his papers, including ones from IEEE, ICC, and IEEE Globecom international conferences. He has received many worldwide awards for his technical contributions, including SCS Prestigious MacLeod Founders Award, Presidential Service Award, SCS Hof for the BIM.
Good morning. Thank you for the introduction. It's long. Thank you. Good morning again. Namaste. Your Excellency, Vice Chancellor Omar, distinguished Dean, distinguished Head of Departments, distinguished faculty colleagues, distinguished industrial guests, and the best of us, our students. It's a pleasure to be here and to be for the second time at SPM University, which, by the way, I start to be affiliated to. The other day somebody told me, did you move there? I said, no. They said, they put your research guild under SPM. I did not put it there. So if you check there my name, you find my publication there at, under SPM University. Well, that's a great honor for me. As introduced, I worked over 25 years in the United States in various universities, University of Missouri, Columbia City, University of New York, University, Fordham University, Monmouth University, and maybe others, yeah. And in 2015, you know, my wife, my mother was not feeling well, and I was the only kid away, and she begged me, I go back to Jordan. So I took leave of absence one day, and I was delighted. I spent over 7 months from the rest of her life there. And I thought I'm settling there in Jordan. Guess what? I am now also professor Republic of China, distinguished professor at the University of Science and Technology China, and distinguished professor in working, because they told me you'll be distinguished professor at Nazarbayev University in Astana. It's a new university established by the president of the Republic of Kazakhstan, and it's American university. They really have the cream of the crop of the best faculty that you find in the world, because it's very good facility. It's outstanding university with outstanding facility. And not just that, I am distinguished honorary distinguished professor at the MIT University, yeah, in India, yeah. So again, it's a pleasure to be here and a pleasure to give a keynote speech shortly. The theme of the conference, I like it very much, you know. I should not forget also that Professor Krishna has done a lot for this university. Not because he's my friend, no. He gave this university good visibility along with his colleagues in the computer science and the College of Sciences in this university. And this conference is really a very good, let us call it, platform and vehicle to give excellent visibility to the university. So the university starts to become known worldwide. Thank you very much, Krishna, for inviting me again. Yeah. The theme of this conference, computing, communication, and data engineering, this is really a hot and emerging field. You know, computing and communication, they became now like, you know, twins. You cannot separate them. In the old days, we used to say they are marriage, first love, but now they are really a must. You cannot live with no communication and computing together. The multiprocessor and parallel processing computing systems, we used to separate them from computer networks. Now you can get a computer network in a chip, you know. Adding data engineering and artificial intelligence and machine learning to the team, that's really a smart idea. Just a few months ago, MIT announced they are establishing a College of Artificial Intelligence. Can you believe it? School of Artificial Intelligence. There is a big money, endowment money from a rich person. He endowed close to $1 billion to establish that school after his name. And now some other also rich person in the ICT technology endowed almost similar to that. And they get matching funds. So they solicit over $2 billion to establish a school. What I want to say, AI and data engineering at one time kind of died, you know. But now it is reborn. And the reason for that is the big data we deal with in our daily life. We deal with a huge volume of data. Each of us individually, look how much gadgets we have. Each of us at least has 3 gadgets, you know, ICT gadget to deal with. So we have a huge volume of data. And the data, for example, in smart homes and smart cities, which I have passion too, as a matter of fact. And Nazarbayev University, it's located in Astana, which is a smart city, which was built about 20 years ago, actually, 20 years ago, brand new city from scratch. I know here Tirupati is being considered a smart city, but this city exists. But there, they started this city from scratch. In 20 years, they built a city. It's an impressive city, you know. The weather is harsh, but it's very impressive city with excellent facilities. What I want to say, we live in smart cities and homes with a huge volume of data. So transportation is a key infrastructure and key resource for any city, a new city, futuristic city to survive. And, you know, in order to manage the traffic, assume God forbid there is an accident and you need to report the accident to the emergency or 911 as they call it in America, or to the police, etc. You need to process the data in a timely manner. The traditional approaches for processing the data will not work. So we need new techniques, we need data analytics, we need a smart processing mechanism by which we could process the data and data mine them, maybe compress them, and send them in a timely manner. Because not sending them in a timely manner may mean loss of a human being. Okay. So that is why I like that adding data engineering to the theme of the conference. It's a good job there. The conference has, I looked at the program, it has impressive technical papers and nice workshops, you know, which is very good. I like the workshop because that could be educational to the faculty and students, especially graduate students. And I saw also international representation in the program. Talking about data engineering, when you talk about data engineering and artificial intelligence and machine intelligence, we should not forget cybersecurity and physical security. And actually, we have a book just published recently on cyber and physical, biometric-based cyber and physical security. What I want to say, these days, all nations in the world, they think of data analytics, cybersecurity. These are two very emerging areas that most nations, they try to establish research and development centers in order to develop technologies and tools to serve the community. You know, ICT technology is like the oxygen for all other technology. And we human beings, can we live with no oxygen? No. The same thing, all critical infrastructure and key resources, which that is the term coined by the Department of Homeland Security in the United States, which include, you know, telecommunication, of course, water utility, electricity utility, financial institution, dams, transportation, highways, bridges, tunnels, you name them. Okay, so these, they need to be protected, they need to be also operated in an efficient way, and ICT technology is that technology that kind of serve all of these technology and let them operate efficiently and economically. So that's why I usually call it the oxygen of all other technology. For cybersecurity, I will be talking after this opening session about biometric technology that we developed. And in biometric technologies for cybersecurity, you have two approaches: behavior, which has to do with social sciences, and physiological. Let's start with the physiological, such as the fingerprint, retina, iris. What else you could have, the face geometry, the hand geometry, and others. The behavior has to do with the behavior of the human being, such as keystroke dynamics, which I was